Flowers always make people better, happier, and more helpful. They are sunshine, food, and medicine for the soul. A beautiful quote by Luther Burbank. Greetings of the day, dear students. I, Ms. Sarika Joshi, Assistant Professor at AISSMS College of Hotel Management and Catering Technology, brings you a session on flower arrangement. In this session, which is part one, on flower arrangement, we shall try to understand the concept and importance of flower arrangement in hotels. We will also learn and get knowledge about the tools, equipments, and accessories used in flower arrangements, and we shall get introduced to different types of flowers and foliage. Let's have a look at what is exactly a flower arrangement. It's an art of organizing or grouping together a plant material to achieve harmony, form, color, texture, to add cheer, joy, life, and beauty to the surroundings. As far as hotels are concerned, flowers or flower arrangements are used extensively. Various types of flower arrangements are chosen as appropriate to the area and occasion. Medium size and round flower arrangements, which are appropriate to guest rooms, lobbies, coffee tables, lounges, and various other public areas, will be seen in hotels. It is an old form, especially which was earlier used in temples and only during festivals. However, now with the help of experts and professionals, it's used extensively in hotels, offices, as well as in hospitals. Before we go into the detail, we have to first understand the basics of flower arrangements. They are categorized here as mechanics, which is nothing but the items used to keep the flowers, foliage, and stems in the container. Some of the equipments used. We shall also get introduced to the containers, bases, and the accessories used in flower arrangement, the type of plant material, and the kind of support needed for these various arrangements. The first and the basic form that we are going to see is a floral foam. As you can see in the adjoining image, this foam is typically green in color and is also called as oasis. It's also called as green foam, and it needs to be soaked in water, and then fresh plant or material can be inserted into it. Dry and light in weight it is initially, but once it is immersed in water, its weight increases almost 30 times when it is filled with water or saturated with water. There are various shapes of floral foam which are available in the market, as you can also see in the adjoining image. The typical ones used are round shape or oval shape, and also a rectangular shape. A desired shape also can be cut with the help of a sharp scissor or a knife to be used in the particular flower arrangement. Now, to hide this particular foam, it should be stored or wrapped in a foil, even to prevent its degradation and to hide it from the actual flower arrangement. The second one that you can see, something like a wire texture, which we call it as a chicken wire, also called as wire mesh or wire netting. As with the help of this wire, a kind of a mesh or a net has been formed. This is used to hold the tall and the heavy stems, because if you see that the vase is smaller in height like this, the one in the image, it will be difficult for it to hold the tall flowers or stems in the container. The 1-inch mesh grid is typically used to cover the floral foam blocks in large displays. So you can say that below this wire mesh, there is a oasis which has been kept, and then the wire mesh has been formed on top of it. So it further helps to hold the tall stems. Let's have a look at the next one, which we call it as a pin holder. As you can see that there are pins or pointed pins over here. It is also called as a needle point holder, or a general term which is used for it is Kensin. A series of sharply pointed pins are firmly held in a solid lead base, which may be either circular or rectangular. As you can note from its shape and the kind of needles used there, it helps in holding the thick and the heavy stems securely by impaling them on the pins. The holder may be used in a shallow dish or in a deep container where it can help to hold the stems together. This is also being shown in the small image which is adjoining to this particular description. The next one is prong. It is type of a floral foam anchor. Okay, it is plastic disc with four vertical prongs. The base of the prong is attached to the container with an adhesive clay and the block is pressed down onto the prongs. We are going to learn about the adhesive clay in our next upcoming slides. As you can see, the next one is a florist cone. A florist cone is also called as a flower tube or a flower funnel. It acts like a miniature vase. It is used in large arrangements where foliage or flowers need to be placed above their stem height. The pointed end is generally tied to a cane, which is then pushed into a floral foam or a chicken wire. Fill the cone with water before inserting the stem is very important. As I already mentioned, adhesive clay or adhesive tape is referred as OSS fix. It is used for securing a prong, as we have seen a prong in the earlier slides, or a pin holder to the container. Adhesive tape is also called as OSS tape and it's mainly used to secure the floral foam or the chicken wire to the container so that it does not move from its place and can easily hold the weight. Another mechanics which is used in flower arrangement is pebbles and marbles. They are used to hold the stems of cut flower. Small pebbles may have been used to hold the stems of cut flowers. The round marbles or the flattened glass nuggets in a glass vase may also add to the attractiveness of the overall display. After the mechanics now, let's have a look at the equipments used in the flower arrangements. These include tools or other aids which are used to ensure that a satisfactory arrangement of plant material is created within the container. Only a few pieces of equipments out of all those are being mentioned in this slide. Some of them are, first one is bucket. A water-filled bucket is a vital piece of equipment for collecting flowers from a garden and for conditioning the blooms before making an arrangement. We have to choose the type of the side handles as the standard free-swinging single handle can damage the flowers during the transport. The next is florist scissors. Ordinary scissors are not useful for cutting the plant stems. They tend to crush the tissues. So we have to choose a pair of florist scissors instead. In these, the blades are short and one is serrated. At the base, there may be a notch to be used for cutting thin wires. The next is mister. A handheld spray bottle to produce a fine mist of water droplets is an aid to keeping an arrangement looking fresh in any weather. Spray the mist lightly above the top of the display as soon as the arrangement is done and then repeat daily at least once or twice. Cicatriers. They are used to cut through thick and woody stems. The garden type is commonly available, but there are some narrower ones which are made especially for the florist. Watering can. This is used for topping up the water supply in the container or re-wetting the florist foam for holding a fresh flower arrangement. We can buy a plastic one or we can even look for some of the important features like the spout should be a bit long and also narrow and it should arise from the base of the can. Floral tape, we have earlier seen in the slides, this stem binding tape made up of plastic and wax paper is almost half an inch wide and is used to cover the artificial stems made of wire. It stretches slightly when wound around the item to be covered and the sticks to itself when warm in the hands. Next is wire. This is used to support the dropping stems and for making posies and also some of the important arrangements. It is used to make false stem for dried and artificial flowers and to bind clumps of blooms together. Three types of wire used are stub wire, rose wire, reel wire. A knife. Buy a craft knife with sharp blade for scraping stems, removing leaves, and stripping away thorns. It is also employed for preparing stem ends by making a sloping cut and occasionally a vertical slit. It may be used to cut floral foam and even to remove the excess clay. Wire cutters. These are useful for heavy cutting work such as cutting chicken wire, plastic stems of artificial flowers, and thick stub wires. Candle holders. Various types of plastic candle holders are available for inserting in floral foam or placing in pin holders. One should ideally buy a metal line holder if the candle is to be lit rather than serve purely as a piece of decoration. Cocktail sticks are also used as equipments of flower arrangements. Use of cocktail stick or a toothpick to make holes in the florist foam for a soft stem or to attach a fruit to the foam holding a flower display. Several sticks are sometimes taped around the base of the candle to secure it firmly in a table arrangements. After looking at the equipment of flower arrangements, let's have a look at some of the containers which are used in flower arrangements. These are the one which will actually hold the flower arrangements, and they may or may not be hidden by any plant material. So they hold their beauty by itself. The container definitely but should be waterproof if fresh flowers are used in that particular container, and the base material from which the container is made determines its also the texture. So you can see here there are three different materials which are used here as a containers. Vase and jug. A vase is a container that is at least as tall as it is wide and is often quite narrow with a restricted mouth. It is a favorite container for cut flowers. However, if a glass vase is used, it is best to partly fill it with the glass nuggets or marbles so that the underwater stems do not look unattractive. As you know, we have to cut the stems before we put it in any container, and if they are not very good to look at, we can cover them with the help of these pebbles. A jug is lid container with a single handle and is useful for old world and natural arrangements. Some of the images are given here for easy understanding. A basket, again, which has been used for flower arrangements, is a very popular container, and many a times dried flower arrangements are made in baskets. Bamboo baskets are easily available for making flower arrangements, and colors may typically be the basic base colors like cream colors. Okay. A good all-purpose selection is a shallow, a little bit of wide basket, usually should be having a holder. Balls and trays. These are shallow containers. Cups and dishes are shallower than the fish bowl type and are widely used for the tabletop arrangements. A taza is a cup born in a tall and a narrow stem. An urn is a robust cup in pottery, stone, or plastic born in a short, stout stem and often with handles and a square base. Wreath frame, a beautiful arrangement you can see which has been put in a wreath which is made here. This can be decorated with the help of seasonal flowers, berries, foliage, and some favorite, and it adds to the very good features for the table and the door sometimes during the festivals, which is commonly used during the Christmas. Choice may be made from a woven cane ring, a wire frame in which moss has been inserted, and a frame covered with real or artificial flowers and foliage will add to the beauty of that particular area. Candle cups. This is a shallow dish of plastic or a metal that holds a block or round of florist foam and has a short stem at the base. This stem is fixed in a candlestick with adhesive clay, which we have seen in the previous slide, and is taped in place before beginning the flower arrangement. Florist foam containers are a plastic container which has internal projections designed to hold a block or a round of florist foams. And there are some other miscellaneous objects also which can add either a beauty or they can be used in flower arrangements, such as shells, wine glasses, shells, driftwood, jelly molds, etc. It is as per your skill and art of doing or making a flower arrangement, you can add different types of materials or object while you are making a flower arrangement. Some of the supports which are used in flower arrangement are tables, sideboards, shelves, fireplace displays, floating arrangements, ground level flower arrangements, a pedestal made up of wood, stone or metal. So what does a support means now? The support refers to the structure on which the container stands. So once you make the flower arrangement, it has to be kept somewhere or it has to be rested somewhere. The usual supports I have noted down, listed down over here, which are tables and sideboards, and a pedestal which can be either made up of wood, stone or metal, and it should act as a good support to your flower arrangement. Dear students, I have used the following references for the material which is used in flower arrangements, which has been shown in this particular PowerPoint presentation. Also, I have referred to Hotel Housekeeping Operations and Management by G. Raghubalan and Smriti Raghubalan. Thank you very much, students, for watching this particular video. Do like and subscribe the video. In the description box of this particular YouTube video, there is a quiz link which will help you to solve the basic questions based on the materials and the equipments used in flower arrangements. We shall discuss the types of flowers and foliage used in flower arrangements and the guidelines of making flower arrangements in the next session. Till then, thank you and goodbye.